Hi, my name is Peter Tallman. I'm the CEO of Klondike Gold. We're standing here in Dawson. It's a beautiful fall day. In 1896, Klondike was the new frontier for the world. Today, Klondike is again the new frontier. We're making new gold discoveries, applying new scientific methods. The Yukon compares favorably to any jurisdiction around the world. From a ranking perspective, it's in the top 10 in the world for governance and safety. From a geologic perspective, I rank it also in the top 10 world-class gold mining district. The potential here has been ignored, but it's off the scale. Right behind me, we're looking at a mountain of white that's white channel gravel, gold-bearing gravels washed down Bonanza Creek from wherever their source was. And 20 million ounces of gold have come from those gravels from 1896 until the present. Until now, there's been no known source. We've discovered the source for the last 6 years. We've done systematic geoscience across the Klondike District, mapped everything, and have located several different areas that have considerable amounts of gold in them in bedrock. I'm going to take you and show you these places today. We're here at the site of the discovery of gold on Eldorado Creek, arguably more significant in some ways than the discovery on Bonanza Creek. It was made by a fellow by the name of Anton Stander and four prospecting partners. And it occurred 14 days after the original Bonanza Creek discovery. So Bonanza Creek over the years has produced 3 million ounces of gold from about 4 kilometers of creek. And Eldorado Creek is richer and has produced a little over 4 million ounces. Anton and his prospecting partners discovered it here. They walked up Bonanza Creek and went all the way to the headwaters, and it had all been staked within 2 weeks of discovery. And they came back and spent the night here on what was an unregarded and unnamed creek at the time. And Anton refused to leave and said, "I'm gonna dig a hole and keep digging here. I'm not leaving until I find gold." And these became some of the richest placer claims in the Klondike. And that's the news that kicked off the discovery and all the rush, the gold rush that is known as the Klondike Gold Rush. We're standing here at Anton Stander's cabin when he lived on Eldorado Creek. I often poke around in these rocks because there's an immense amount of gold have gone through this particular site over the years. And I'm always just trying to poke in there and see if he left any nuggets in the fireplace. So far, I haven't found any. But I always say every day when I pass by, I always ask Anton to wish me luck. And I hope perhaps his original luck helps me find gold here too. We're staying in front of the Violet Mine. The headframe behind me was constructed in 1904 following the discovery of gold in quartz veins in bedrock here in 1902. There's three or four of these old mine sites, and they all recovered gold in bedrock. And just this alone means that there is gold in the bedrock in the Klondike. Where we're standing geographically, we're directly above Eldorado Creek, and the Eldorado Creek segment right adjacent to us has produced 4 million ounces of gold from placer. Somewhere that placer gold was derived from bedrock, and this is one of the sources. For Klondike Gold, this is one of our main exploration targets. We're focusing on Lone Star and the Stander Zone, but this is, in its own right, a substantial target for us in the future. We're standing in front of the Lone Star Mine headquarters. This is a place that links the original past 1896 gold rush to today. And so there's been a 125-year history of underground mining successful here. And it's important because here we are 125 years later, back more or less in the same area, proving that they were right, but there's vastly more gold here than they ever suspected. Searching around in the garbage dump left over from that period, the midden, there's this boot, and this boot has fascinated me ever since I found it. And what it shows is the conditions of the day were probably terrible, and the conditions that miners went through, and these are underground miners. So this boot in particular is a leather boot, and it has two soles on it now, the original sole, which was nailed on, metal nails, and then obviously had a leak, and another layer of leather was nailed on top of it. If you can imagine standing on ice, permafrost here, with metal holding your boot together, it would freeze your feet and ankles really quickly. They'd come back to the mine building, read a newspaper, and because it's so cold, particularly in the winter, they're gluing the newspaper onto the boards for a little bit of insulation. The mine building behind me exemplifies the past and the history of the Klondike, the original history of the Klondike. And what we're doing today is providing a modern take to it. And we're doing mineral delineation of a gold deposit right now that is going to replace that building with a 125-year update of new technology, new methods, and hopefully a mineral deposit that lasts many years into the future. We are here to make history again. We're standing on the Lone Star Zone. The Lone Star Zone is the principal zone of gold mineralization for Klondike gold today. Originally, some gold was discovered here just after the turn of the century, 1902, 1903. And that came following the 1896 discovery of gold in Bonanza Creek, which is just downhill from here. What we've learned recently is that the Lone Star Zone is the source of the Bonanza Creek placer gold. So in Bonanza Creek, there's been 3 million ounces of gold come from the creek over the last 125 years, and we're standing on the source of it. The Lone Star Zone itself, as we know it today, we have 3 kilometers of length in drill holes with gold mineralization in them, and 5 kilometers of length of gold in outcrop and gold samples. Today, we are working on systematically drilling the Lone Star Zone with the objective of establishing a gold mineral resource within the next year or so. Once we attain that, that will be a transformative event for Klondike Gold.
My name's Ian Perry. I'm Vice President of Klondike Gold Corporation. We've identified a major regional structure along which are spotted a number of gold showings, including the main one on our project right now, Lone Star, but also extending some distance as far as Dominion Creek and the Gold Run Creeks. In addition to that, we've also identified an alteration pattern similar to alteration patterns around other major deposits in the world. From the initial recognition of it, we can go back to older holes that we've drilled in the past and start to pull these alteration patterns out, such that we have, I think now, a pretty well-defined specific set of rocks to look for.
Modern geological science has advanced so much in the last 20 years. In the Klondike, we've realized that the gold deposits here, they're called orogenic gold deposits. That model wasn't invented until the 80s. And it's only really been applied around the world globally in the last 10, 20 years. So it's brand new science. There's new ways of looking at the rocks. We're using that and producing innovative new maps and the geology and putting structure together to locate gold deposits. It's an exciting time because we are on the forefront of science, trying to use those tools to delineate mineral deposits. Northern Europe, Scandinavia, have much greater infrastructure and have had it for a longer period of time than the north of Canada, just in general. And so it's easier to develop gold deposits or any deposit if you have infrastructure and power around you. That hasn't happened yet in the Yukon. The Klondike Highway that gets to Dawson was built in World War II to help defend Alaska from the Japanese. And that's the only road to the north, really, in this side of Canada. With more discoveries and more economic activity here, there's more incentive for governments to build more infrastructure. And more infrastructure makes it cheaper to find more discoveries, and the cycle will continue. The area has never been mapped until now. That's as shocking as that seems. It's been around and known for 125 years, 20 million ounces of gold to come from here, and there was never a geology map until now. And we've done some unique things in terms of exploring and using all the new information that's available to us to make discoveries. One of the unique things about the Klondike is that all the gold here is visible. Coarse gold you can see with the naked eye. So that's unusual in the world, and that helps us figure out where there's lots of it. Where the next big area is going to come from, I'm biased, but I think it's here. In 6 years, we found a lot of gold, proven there's gold in them there hills. The future is bright for Klondike Gold.